Number one is, of course, the Eiffel Tower. As it is without a doubt the most famous attraction in all of Paris, it is also the most populated, especially on the weekends. So, it is best to visit the Eiffel Tower on weekdays, and you must book your tickets in advance if you want to travel to the top of the tower. Number two is the Louvre, one of the world's largest museums, housing nearly 35,000 objects from prehistory to the 19th century. Number three is Notre Dame, probably the most well-known cathedral in the entire world, thanks in large part to Victor Hugo's novel, The Hunchback of Notre Dame, is located on the eastern half on the Ile de la Cité along the Seine. Number four is Opera. One of the most beautiful buildings in all of Paris, Opera is not a final destination, but rather a quick stop in the 12th arrondissement. Number five is Sacré-Cœur. A popular landmark located at the summit of Montmartre, Sacré-Cœur is the highest point in Versailles. While not centrally located in Paris, if you can only fit in one day trip during your visit, make it to the Palace de Versailles. At number seven is Centre Pompidou, located in the 4th arrondissement of Paris, near Les Halles and the Marais. At number eight is the Tuileries Garden. Located between the Louvre Museum and the Place de la Concorde, this public garden is a great place to take a break. Arc de Triomphe. Located at the western end of the famous Champs-Élysées, the Arc de Triomphe is the linchpin of the historical axis which extends from the Louvre. At number 10, the Pantheon. Located in the Latin Quarter in Paris and a short walk from Jardin de Luxembourg, this one-time church now functions as a secular mausoleum, housing the remains of some of the most distinguished French citizens, including Victor Hugo and Marie Curie.